In this video, I'll say a little bit about the general idea behind rich get richer phenomena and models thereof. So the starting point is an observation that the popularity of many things is distributed according to a power law, or something that's power law-like, has a long tail. For example, book sales. There are very, very many books that sell very, very few copies, and there are a few books that are wildly popular. And if you plot a histogram of that, you would see a long tail. The story is similar, say, for scientific papers, how often they get cited. Most scientific papers get cited very rarely, once or twice, if at all. And then there's some very, very popular scientific papers, influential scientific papers, that get cited many, many, many times. Again, there's a long tail, perhaps described by a power law. Another example is the popularity of websites. Some websites have very, very many links pointing to them, or have very, very many hits in a day, whereas other websites, many, many more websites, are not popular at all and have just one or two links to them, if any links at all. So all of these phenomena can be, if one looks at data, looks like they might be described by a power law. So then the question is, why is that? So one answer would be, well, because some web pages are better, some scientific papers are better, some books are better, some music, some songs are better, and so on. And that's surely part of the story. But it could also be that there's a different and alternative dynamic at play, and that's this rich gets richer idea. So let me describe in general terms what that might be. So here's the idea. Let's say I'm researching a topic, maybe power laws, and I'm trying to find references about a certain aspect of power laws so I can learn more about them. So one way I might do that is that I might start with one paper and then look in the references for that paper to see who they cite as I try to learn more about a certain topic. So if I do that, and then eventually maybe I write a paper, and I'm going to cite some of the papers that I found. And so in that dynamic, I'm much more likely to find papers that have already been cited many times if I'm using citations as a way to figure out what papers to find. I could also do, I mean, that's not the only way I would find papers, but that would be a primary way. And if I did a search on Google Scholar, it often returns hits ranked more highly if those papers have been cited more often. So the idea is maybe originally there's a handful of papers and they're all equally good, but then just by chance one or two of them happen to get cited more often. Well, then those papers are now have an advantage. That little initial advantage can grow, and those papers would get cited more often, and those papers, and then more often still, and so on. Another example might be maybe I'm looking for a book to read, something for the next airplane flight I have to take. I might ask people for recommendations, and I'm going to get recommended books that people have read. So a certain book is more likely to get recommended to me the more often it's been read. Therefore, I'm more likely to read it, and then somebody might ask me for a recommendation, and I would recommend to them the book that I had just read because other people had recommended it to me. So the idea is, excuse me. The idea is that in all of these systems, there is a little bit of an instability. An initial random bump in population can grow very quickly and lead to some superstar books, some hits, some really popular papers. And in this view, those highly cited papers or really popular books or websites aren't necessarily the best. Maybe they just got lucky and then rode that advantage to a really large citation count or really high popularity. Now, of course, both of these things could be in play at the same time. Some books are better than others. Surely that's true. But also, I think it's true that surely there's some of these random effects as well. I'll return to that later in this section. But for now, what I want to do is investigate a particular model that leads to one of these rich gets richer dynamics. And we won't go all the way into the mathematical details because that's a bit beyond what we can do. But let's specify the model and look at a few results. So I'll do that in the next video. And then we'll step back and talk more broadly about the sorts of phenomena that these types of models can apply to, and look at some of the applications and implications of them.